UBA 9-month financial report shows that 9-month interim report at the bank recorded about strong earnings growth during the period. So that's 36.1% year-on-year growth in earnings per share to 2.94 naira compared to 2.16 naira in 2020. So overall profit before tax went up by 36.4% year-on-year higher at around 122.2 billion naira. So interest income grew by 8.4% year-on-year to 343.71 billion naira. However, cash and bank balances declined 12% year-on-year. Profit after tax grew by 35.6% year-on-year to 104.6 billion naira. So income tax expense went up by 41.2%. However, so operating expenses inch higher by 6.9%. That's the report, a snapshot of UBA 9-month financial report 2021. But let's look quickly at Unilever. How much is Unilever doing? Because it's earnings season and a lot of earnings are trickling in, financial year trickling in. And look at the revenue of Unilever's third quarter 2021 unaudited result. This is not yet audited. This is the unedited result of the Unilever report. So revenue grew by 2.5% year-on-year to 19.73 billion in the third quarter of 2021. So you have the earnings per share of 0.06 against a loss per share of 27 kobo recorded in the third quarter of 2020. So performance was supported by 12.5% top line growth and a surge in finance income up to 284.0% year on year. So revenue went up and stood at 58.72 billion naira, primarily driven by strong avenue growth. So you have food segment declining, you also have revenue going up. So that's a bit of a contrast there. But let's talk to our analyst who is standing by, Mr. Ambrose Omodion, is Chief Research Officer, Invest Data Consulting Limited. He joins us now via the telephone. Thank you, Mr. Omodion, for your time. Looking at the results yesterday and some of the earnings trickling in, the food sector, the food segment of the shares of the company of Unilever went down, declined there. But meanwhile, of course, the gross earning went up. So let's start from there. How do you, address or analyze this contrast?
Actually, when you see company coming back from a loss position to position, they're about to see all this kind of mixed performance. But the good thing is that the third quarter result have hit the market so far and supported the market. You can see a positive reaction to Unilever number, PZ, and the Police Microfinance and the result last week Friday. Because that investors are seeing value in these stocks because the numbers are giving them an insight where the business are going. Especially, don't forget that anywhere in the world, their quarter results give you an insight what is expected from the company at the end of the current financial year. That is where both in Nigeria and outside Nigeria, once it's come to third quarter results, people want to pick position with it because it gives you an insight, what you should spend in the full financial year that will end in December that year, especially those that have their financial year with the calendar of January toward the December. And Unilever is among those that have the same calendar, that is why they give their third quarter. And you see that there's improvement in their top line and bottom line, despite there's a little decline in their food, subsidiary or subsegment of the company. But that also a reflection of what is happening in the economy, that yes, consumption has dropped because people earnings have dropped, inflation are also hitting some people's source of livelihood. But the good thing is that all the data that came from consumer goods, there's an improvement. It tells you that the economy is also recovering, because if you want to really test whether the economy is doing well or not, you look at the food manufacturing or the food and beverage sector to see the rate of consumption.
Right.
If you have seen the number that the one that came from Nestle was positive, the one that came from PZ was positive, the one that came from Unilever was positive, that's why the next one you are just seeing for Unilever. But all the numbers shows that something is happening in that sector. But what we are looking at this one, that every investor wants to go where there is value, think that the value that this company has also diversified. You know, Unilever has done into tea business, into like Nespresso, into Nescafe. They are going to tea business, which also has also reflecting on their performance. Nobody that will take that to Unilever Nigeria. For me, these are signs that I consider that since then, they believe that their price has been on the up direction. People have spent this money, and the market has opened. It has been almost 9%, 10% margin for the day. That means people are seeing value in that kind of norm. Every company that is coming up with the good numbers. That's good, but the numbers are okay, that's by this means. I think only that we have to look at this. We have seen the third quarter, we have seen the fourth quarter. Remember, I have given an insight to which kind of dividends you expected from Unilever at the end of the year. It might not be
right
strong to support the price, but because they will up their payout a little. Also, capital appreciation is key. People that are in pain now is the traders that are paying the stock now. They are not interested in the event that will come in next year, first quarter. But since the good number that market is doing, the big money are coming out, why the long-term investor also be looking at the stock? Is what is happening in Unilever. But you mentioned that UBA, I would tell you, UBA has kind of give an insight to what we should expect from the financial, especially the focus, the first year bank. Stamp Big released the result. It was a slap to the meeting first when they saw that result. But still, market reacted to that result positively that day. But now, we are seeing the number that from UBA give you an insight to what UBA is capable of doing at the end of financial year. This is the fourth time we are seeing UBA earnings above 270 Google. And almost 290 Google or 306, if I might say that, the earnings for third quarter. And this kind of number we saw in UBA is when in 2018, when the stock hit as high as 30 naira, that it is around 2 naira 57 Google. Now we are still at any pressure of almost 3 naira. Tell you that at the end of the year, you pay by cross close 4 naira or hit 4 naira any pressure. That alone should give you an insight to what you expect from UBA. For me, the investor in UBA should just relax on the numbers and show that it's really an African bank. That they are putting in a plan that we can see it at the bottom of the line of the company that they put their bottom line with almost 37%, from about around 37 billion to 104 billion. Tell that something is working for UBA. And also, don't forget that when UBA cut their the previous year, they said they are using that money to kind of like credit to the countries where they are operating because those countries need money work to survive, to run the economy. And now, if the economy is mounting back globally because of those people that have their money are paying them, and also don't forget that oil price also is on increase, and the banks in Nigeria are highly exposed to oil sector and power sector.
All right.
We expect to see more of this result from
more of this, right?
Except Japan. That means we are looking forward to see results from State Bank, from First Bank, from Africa, from Access Bank, and the GGB.
Right. Okay, I think we should leave it there. Thank you so much. Ambrose Omodion is Chief Research Officer, Investigator Consultant. Thank you for your time on the program today.
Thank you.